He's a New York Times bestselling author, speaker, entrepreneur, and longtime partner of Oprah Winfrey. Stedman Graham has a new book out, How to Be an Effective Leader.
It's called Identity Leadership. It's based on his philosophy that a leader cannot lead others until he can first lead himself. Good to see you, Stedman. Thanks
hey,
for being back
Robin,
with us.
Good morning.
So this is your 12th book. You said this is your favorite. Why?
Well, it's called Identity Leadership, and based on the philosophy that you can't lead anybody else until you first lead yourself. So it's about self-actualization and taking charge of your own development by taking information and making it relevant to who you are. So that's the key ingredients in terms of authenticity, in terms of being grounded in something that you really love and care about. So you can be effective and you can perform at the highest possible level based on your talents, your skills, your passions, your abilities.
Well, this is a good transition because you talk about being who you are, but one of the big takeaways I took from this about being a leader is being positive. And what if genetically you're not a positive person, like some people?
Yeah, if you're...
He's not wrong about me, by the way, so I'm listening.
Are you hardwired for negativity?
Yeah. I think so.
Which means that what did you learn in that household for 18, 19 years?
Ooh.
Your parents did the best they could based on what they knew.
Yeah.
What did you learn? And so you picked up the energy in that household. And so if the foundation of your existence is negative, then everything you look at the glass half empty before you look at the glass half full. And so that is a transformational process. I mean, if you can transform that energy from positive to negative to positive, you've transformed. And that's part of the problem.
Well, does this happen with people? And maybe some people are just naturally leaders, some are naturally not leaders, and maybe more introverted. Is there still a way they can use these principles to change their lives?
Well, this is the process of for self-actualization. For me, I'm often defined by race and defined by family. Two special needs brother in my family. That was defined, of course, by my relationship a lot of times. And so it's not how the world defines you. What I learned is how you define yourself, but there's no process for that. School doesn't teach you that. It teaches you how to memorize, take tests, repeat the information back, get labeled with a grade, and 2 weeks later you forget the information. In a life, you end up doing the same thing over and over every single day. You're not even conscious of self-empowerment and self-efficacy because you wake up in the morning, you wash your face, you brush your teeth, you get something to eat, you get the kids off school, work all day, come home in the afternoon, spend time with the family, watch TV, you go to bed, maybe you dream. That's Monday. So you're not doing anything.
Have you been spying on me?
So the key here is that you're a thinker. Can you engage yourself in the real world as opposed to doing this all day, doing nothing, talking about nothing, going nowhere?
Watching Netflix.
And can you turn the learning system around where you take information and make it relevant to your development? That's the problem with our young people not being able to maximize their potential based on who you are. That's the problem with people not growing. That's the problem with the middle class going backwards. Wages are low. 21st century says you have to be a self-directed learner. You have to be a lifelong learner. How do you do that the way the traditional system is set up? It's really a follower system. And until you turn that around, you can never be able to address some of the issues you're talking about.
So here's a specific example that you have in the book that I really liked. You say, a goal is not, I want to lose weight. You say, a goal is, I'm going to run 3 miles tomorrow morning at 11 a.m.
Well, even a bigger goal is to have a vision to create a lifestyle around you so that you become the most important person in the world and that you have a process for setting goals. And it starts with love is the most powerful word in the world. So it starts with loving yourself and organizing everything you love. So you can put that on the vision board and then create goals around that. All of us are equal because all of us have 24 hours. The question is, what do you do with the 24 hours? Most people are not going anywhere because they're not productive and they're not focusing on organizing their 24 hours around them to empower themselves.
So I just got to take that first step. That's the first step is the hardest.
You need the 9-step success process. I need to sit down with you and we need to go over this. We need to reorganize your life and you need to be able to take the resources of the world, make everything relevant to you every single day so you can develop a process of continuous improvement so you're better today than you were yesterday.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes.
This is going to turn
you
it
have
around
it.
For
yeah.
me.
You have it.
See, it's like we all have it. It's just we got to do it.
Larry, you got it.
Okay. See, he's all over
I'm stuck
it,
with
sure.
her.
Thanks, Stedman. The book is called Leadership or Identity Leadership. You can get more information at StedmanGraham.com. Great to see you again.
Thanks, Stedman.
Thanks for being here.